please stand up? Yes. I will ask 9 others to stand up as well. So rise, please. The first 2 rows. No? Yeah? The first 2 rows, please. Just stand. Okay, that's a very nice group. You 10 represent the majority of people who think, I will always live a healthy life. But sorry, I got bad news for you. The reality is that 7 out of you will be in a doctor's office sooner than expected. Oops. Because of your own lifestyle choices. For 7 out of you means getting older is getting ill by your own fault. You may sit down again. Thanks for making my point. And concerning those 7, don't worry too much. It's just the average. Medical science has improved during the last 50 years enormously. And we are still learning about our human body. But doctors look only and focus only on the aspects they are an expert in. And medical professionals do not look to an entire human, but and to discover the reason, what the reason is behind their illness. And that is still common in modern fact-based medical practice. People get a prescription, and they suppress the signal the body is giving them about their own bad lifestyle. When they are cured, they stick to the old lifestyle. And you can imagine the body gives another signal and another pill is given. And we can all imagine how that story ends. When I turned 38 and I would not have changed my lifestyle, I would have been part of the following horrible and horrible statistics. Let's take a look to the average Dutch people concerning their healthiness. And let's focus on the 3 main issues, illnesses, caused by lifestyle. First, 1 out of 4 die by cardiovascular diseases. And recently, I had the honor to speak on a health symposium, and there was, I was telling 70% of all the people would get ill because of bad lifestyle. And then a cardiologist said to me, Peter, concerning our area, you can even increase that to 95%. Second, overweight. 50%, also over here, is overweighted. And 15% of that, of those people, have a BMI higher than 30, which means obese. Third, burnout rates are getting higher and higher. 13% of our working population has burnout-related illnesses. And 65% of all the people who had a burnout are stating that they never reached the energy level they had before. And also trust in their own body was gone. People think that if they choose for a lifestyle more healthy, they will lose a lot of fun in life. And because of that, there's only a minor group changing their lifestyle, and the majority sticks to the old. But then again, if you stick to the old, you will end up in the more than 50% people getting a heart disease, get overweighted, or get burnout-related illnesses. And that is 1 out of 2. And of course, we all know that drinking and smoking and not exercising is not healthy for you. And now and then I'm told that, Peter, I know a person older than 90, drinking, smoking, not exercising, and still living. And then I say, okay, please take a look at the Kaus curve. Concerning lifestyle, the Kaus curve, 95% of the majority covers the median. And for that majority, lifestyle interventions determine the degree of health and happiness. There is a big misunderstanding concerning being healthy. What does it mean, being healthy? Being healthy doesn't mean you don't have an illness or a disease. Being healthy means you are happy for no reason, so that you are capable of all the things you want to do and all the things you now and then need to do. Being healthy also means you have a lot of energy and you can take that for granted. We have to make a mind shift, and that is the reason why I'm here. It is choose or lose. And we have to take our own responsibility for our own health. And I know what I'm talking about. I woke up the other day in 2004, 5:30 in the morning. I walked into the bathroom, looked into the mirror, and I started shaving. And I heard myself saying, "Peter, how long are you going to live this life fast and furious?" And from that very moment, my life took a turn. Just slightly, not too fast, but very consequent and in a very resolute way. The nicest thing I find out is that changing your lifestyle isn't that difficult. I never had the feeling that I was losing more than I was gaining. And very small steps made very big, important changes in my life. And now you might think, "Yeah, Peter, nice. Preaching is something different than practicing." In fact, that is your inner voice speaking, in medical terms called the amygdala. And that little guy inside of you might even tell you it is not worth changing it and all the effort, and you will fail anyway. But the trick is not to challenge that little guy inside. And the way to do it is think big, but act small. How much time would you be able in a day to take a time out? Not working, not reading, not exercising, just doing nothing. Although you do a lot. Is that an hour? Is that 30 minutes? Is that 15? 10, 5? I would say start with 1 minute. 1 minute to stare at something. 1 minute to start the life-changing experience. And why staring? Staring helps us to relax. And relax brings us the elimination of unnecessary impulses. And it also brings the recovery of a full day. So there we go. Choose an object. A book, a newspaper, your cat. It can be really anything. A plant, a bush, some nature. And then focus on it. And when you are focusing, then you will experience in your body that you might probably 1 minute ago too tense. And your body will even probably talk to you. You are tired or you are stressed. If others would follow my path, becoming the best version of yourself, how would that look? Really aiming for a good health. Consciously balancing between mental and physical health. If you all would start here today, being the best version of yourself, and if we would start in Holland as the first country, and then experience the sheer abundance of joy and happiness and energy, I would say that would be my world I would endless proud of. So I say, get started and get better. That to me is an idea worth spreading. Thank you so much.